His lyrics inspired generations. Award-winning country music star and actor Kris Kristofferson has died, aged 88.
The American country music star and actor Kris Kristofferson has died at the age of 88. The Grammy Award-winning singer was best known for his role in the original A Star Is Born film from 1976. His family said he passed away peacefully on Saturday at his home in Hawaii. Our media and arts correspondent David Sillitoe has been back looking back at his life.
Lay your head upon my pillow.
It was Kris Kristofferson's mix of songwriting talent and rugged charm that turned this Texan oil rig helicopter pilot into one of the biggest stars of the 70s.
I was born upon the tide, and with the sea I did abide.
Alongside Willie Nelson, Johnny Cash and Waylon Jennings, he took a bit of rock's attitude and musical freedom to create a new sound. Outlaw country.
You're finished. You're finished.
And there was more than a touch of that mood in his movie roles in films like Convoy.
Because we have the brightest world.
And A Star Is Born, in which he appeared with Barbra Streisand.
I'm sorry this booze will blew your brain.
He played a singer with a taste for the excesses of the music world, and there were more than a few parallels with his own life at the time.
If you feel that way about it,
go to hell.
There are so many ways that I got away with murder, just blowing, rolling cars, you know, having accidents on motorcycles, playing full tilt.
Bullet holes and rifles.
But that hard-living Texan image was far from the whole story. He'd been a Rhodes Scholar at Oxford University and an Army captain who was at one point offered a teaching post at West Point. His family did not approve of him abandoning the military for music.
Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose.
It's perhaps not a surprise that his best-known song, Me and Bobby McGee, sung here by his girlfriend at the time, Janis Joplin, was a celebration of freedom and escape.
Help me make it through the
And here, with his wife at the time, Rita Coolidge, a little reminder of the intense, rough-hewn charisma of Kris Kristofferson.
Help me make it through the night.
David Sillitoe there, looking back at the life of Kris Kristofferson.
Kristofferson's family said that he passed away peacefully on Saturday in his home in Hawaii.
Not surprisingly, there have been tributes from many of his co-stars. Barbra Streisand from A Star Is Born, of course, recalling the first time she saw him perform live. She said she knew he was something special.
And Dolly Parton tweeted, "What a loss, what a great loss, what a great writer, what a great actor, what a great friend," adding that she will always love him.
We can speak now to the BBC Radio 2 Country Show presenter, Bob Harris. Hi, Bob.
Good morning.
It's always good to hear your thoughts and
Thank
your
you.
Memories, because you met Kris Kristofferson, didn't you? What was he like?
I was a massive fan. I am a massive fan, you know. He was... he represented what was known as outlaw country. You know, rather than from Nashville... He did try his career in Nashville, but it didn't really work there. So he went back to Texas, formed the Outlaws. That whole phrase of outlaw country is what he represented to me, because that that supergroup that he formed with Johnny Cash and Waylon Jennings and Willie Nelson, at that moment in the 70s, that really was, you know, left field. Outlaw country, he had that fantastic image about him, and a strength, I think, also too, as an actor and as a singer. I think he was absolutely magnetic.
When you met him, I think it was with his wife at the time, Rita Coolidge. We've been showing some of the clips of them singing together. It was certainly steamy, I think you could sort of say, but he had that attraction, didn't he? He had a real charisma about him.
Yes, he did, and I remember that even now. I mean, it's many years ago, but I remember that session extremely well. Well, it was live, you know, the programme was live, the Old Grey Whistle Test in those days. And the chemistry between the two of them, well, you saw it yourself, you know. I mean, it was steamy, it was kind of electric. They were so into the moment. But again, it sort of represented what Kris Kristofferson was to me at the time, that he was a person that, you know, he didn't really care about, you know, creating a good impression. He was always just himself. And I think that was fantastic. And even fairly recently, he did a gig. I introduced him, actually, the gig in Kenwood, in Hampstead, of all places. This was probably about 5 or 6 years ago. And he was still, I mean, absolutely still so charismatic.
And it's interesting, just looking through these pictures, we see him there with Rita Coolidge, with Janis Joplin, with Barbra Streisand. Of course, he'll be remembered for his partnerships almost as much as he'll be remembered in his own solo right, won't he?
Absolutely, yes. I mean, he very much enjoyed the company of women, and women very much enjoyed his company too. It was interesting what Barbra Streisand was saying about him, because the star is born. You know, he wasn't just a singer. He wasn't just an outlaw figure. He was a genuinely convincing actor, because again, I think he could be himself without thinking outside of that in any way and put his heart and soul into whatever role he was playing. So, you know, I think that added to his charismatic image, if you like.
Bob, it's always good to hear from you, and I'm sure you'll be paying tribute on your show this week, right?
I will, Thursday evening at 9 o'clock.
Look forward to it. Bob Harris, thank you so much for joining us, remembering the life of Kris Kristofferson.